wasn't expecting any visitors. My, my, my. You certainly do look a little bit worn out from your travels. Oh, just look at my terrible manners. I'm Agatha. It's so nice to meet you. Now, what brings you all the way out here? Oh, don't worry about me. I'm just fine out here. My husband, rest his poor soul, saw to it that our house was well protected from the elements and the inhabitants of the wastes. Well, that's kind of you to say. Yes, he's gone. After he built this place, we spent many happy years together. We decided to cut off contact with the outside world and just depend on each other for comfort and company. Oh, goodness, no. I have a supply caravan that passes here maybe once a week. I trade with them for whatever I need, and I stock up enough till they return. Well, I always have my husband's old radio set to fall back on. I used it once in an emergency when a group of raiders was getting a bit too close for comfort to my house. Otherwise, I use it to broadcast my so-called music I play from my homemade violin. Oh, you are a clever one. Yes, that's exactly the problem that I have with it. It doesn't quite play all of the notes correctly, and I have to constantly tinker with it. Yes, my husband was very proud of the setup. He tinkered with that thing for years to get it working. I've tried to use it to get whatever I need, but I've never gotten a reply. Thank you. Well, my husband had his hobbies. I'm afraid mine was making that sorry instrument. I only wish I could replace it with something better. But now that you mention it, yes, there is. My training depends on my violin. Without it, I have nothing to play, no way to make music. If you can bring me a violin, a better one, I'd feel much more secure. Yes, very sad, isn't it? Sad to think that no more musical instruments will ever be made the old way ever again. Well, fortunately, I know where perhaps the last real violin in the world exists. If you give me your word that you will recover it, I will tell you more. Well, that's just so sweet of you. I feel bad sending you off with nothing like this. I have a small amount of ammunition that my husband left behind. A box of odds and ends. I don't think I've opened it in years. If you do this for me, you're welcome to take whatever you need. Oh, I don't think I've been this happy in years. As promised, here's the key to the ammunition box. It's right under the radio table. Before you leave, I have some information that may help you, at least a place to begin. It all starts with my great-great-grandmother Hilda back in 2077, before the bombs fell. Of a kind, yes. Hilda sent a good deal of letters to my great-grandmother Mary, who passed them on, and so forth. I suppose the correspondence could be considered a diary of sorts. It certainly is a long time. That precious instrument has been through a lot. Anyway, Hilda was quite a special woman, classically trained and exceptionally talented at the violin. Her pride and joy was her Stradivarius violin. I can only imagine how exquisite this instrument must have been. When the war reared its head, she was invited by Vault-Tec into Vault 92. They claimed the vault would be dedicated to preserving musical talent. Vault-Tec was always promoting the vaults being used for the preservation of the arts and all that nonsense. Hilda couldn't pass on a chance to meet many of the other musical talents of the world, so she accepted their invitation. Then the bombs fell, the vault was sealed, and my family never heard from her again. She kept it in a special pressurized case. Inside the case is the perfect temperature and humidity for the instrument. If the case is still functioning, the Stradivarius would be in perfect shape. Hilda's Stradivarius was named the Soi Stradivarius. All of them had names. That's what I want you to get. That's the catch. I have no idea where it is. I'd suggest making your way to Vault-Tec headquarters in the D.C. ruins. That would be a good place to begin. Good luck! She was quite a special woman. Hilda was her name, classically trained and exceptionally talented at the violin. Her pride and joy was her Stradivarius violin. I can only imagine how exquisite this instrument must have been. When war reared its head, she was invited by Vault-Tec into Vault 92. They claimed the vault would be dedicated to preserving musical talent. Happily, she accepted. After she entered Vault 92, the bombs fell, and the story as I know it ends. Not too much, I'm afraid. It was fabricated way back in 1714 by a famous Italian craftsman named Antonio Stradivari. He had made a bunch of Stradivarius violins, actually, and each one was individually named over time to identify them. They are regarded as the most outstanding instruments ever made, and no two sound alike, they say. Incredible! Since the bombs fell, laying waste to most of the world, it may be safe to say that this could be the last surviving violin of its kind. Well, from my great-great-grandmother's diaries, I have deduced that she had a special pressurized case created for it. Hopefully, the Soi Stradivarius was in the case when she... Well, you know. I hope you're not thinking of doing anything dishonest. You gave me your word. Well, okay. I'm sorry. I wish I did. All I know is that Vault-Tec intended it to be a protective environment for the world's musical talent. When the bombs fell, the vault was sealed, and the rest is a mystery. Perhaps when you find it, you can find some sort of a record of what occurred inside. From what I gather, it's located in the ruins of D.C. I got the location from one of the supply caravans. They told me it had extremely high security and something they call a mainframe inside. I'd imagine it's quite dangerous. I'd be careful if I was you. Be careful. I don't want to be responsible for getting you killed. Thank you.
beast! God! Prepare for your death! Your time just run out! What have you got on your mind?
continued existence is unlawful.
Sir, I encountered three ferals on my patrol. This was somewhere around 0300 hours, I think, and it was dark, so they saw me first. I discharged my firearm four times, fatally striking two of the three. My weapon jammed before I could fire on the third target. Just then, I realized it wasn't engagement. I knew our orders were to report anything unusual, and, well, I thought that was pretty strange. He actually followed me back on his own. We put him in the trailer with the other, and he's been quiet as you like. Strangest thing I've ever seen.
Thank you.
time, Ares! Done! careful!
Experiment is going exactly as planned. We're subjecting the residents to extremely low-frequency white noise, regular intervals through the loudspeaker system. Using the soundproof recording studios and the musicians was an inspired idea. Kudos to the Vault-Tec selection committee on their shrewdness.
Over.
I'm a bit encouraged by the latest batch of data. Seems that 33% of the subjects are now lapsing into a trance-like state on occasion. When in this state, we're fairly certain that suggestion and programming of the subject can be applied. We've begun testing this by implanting subtle cues in affected subjects, making them scratch their ear or constantly fix their hair. So far, I'm happy to report a 100% success rate on this implementation method. Disaster today. One of our test subjects, V920717, murdered three other residents in a fit of unbridled rage, the likes of which I've never seen. It took almost 23 shots before the security team took him down. This subject has no history of violence or mental instability whatsoever. My concern is that this subject is one of our most successful implant recipients, able to execute complex instructions during a trance state. Situation is getting out of hand. Over half the population of the vault is exhibiting savage tendencies. I can only assume our noise experimentation has awakened some dormant part of their psyche, brought their primitive nature to the surface. In essence, I feel that they are almost psychologically devolving. I was stupid for rushing these experiments. Now over 35 people are dead. Discovered. Just before he died, one of the security team members told me everything. The Overseer has been implanting these murderous intentions in the entire vault population without my knowledge. Using the loudspeakers in the dorms instead of just the studios, he subjected everyone to the white noise as they slept. He then implanted combat suggestions he claims came from Vault Tech itself. He must be completely insane. No observation, no controls. I'm going to have to confront him now and make him pay for what he's done. Half the vault is dead. The other half, fighting for its life. Good luck to all of us. And may God have mercy on our souls.
Good time.